Shalom Lachem, Shalom. I'm Messianic Rabbi Zev Porat. Our ministry has been receiving many, many emails over the years about studying the books of the rabbis, such as the Talmud, such as the Gemara, such as the Zohar, and many other kind of books written by rabbis. And my answer is always, we are followers of Yeshua HaMashiach. We're followers of Jesus. We are not to follow the rabbis. The rabbis do not have the Holy Spirit. In fact, most of these books were written to contradict the sayings of Yeshua HaMashiach. So why are we to follow the rabbis? And I think there's a little bit of a misunderstanding because the nations, the Gentiles, the believers around the world, they're praying for Israel. They're rejoicing with Israel. They understand that they're spiritually Israel. And I think that in that search for the quest, sometimes they have a little bit of misunderstandings about some Bible verses, and they seem to think that it's okay if we study these rabbinic books, but it's not okay because no one makes it to the Father but only through Yeshua HaMashiach. And the written word of God is only what Jesus wrote, what Yeshua wrote, and what the prophets wrote under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit. Any other books written by rabbis or religious books are not to be read because they do not have the indwelling of the Ruach HaKodesh, the Holy Spirit. And I think that one of the Bible verses that has a little bit of a misunderstanding is the book of Yochanan, John chapter 4, verse 22, where it says, "You worship what you do not know. We worship what we know, for salvation is from the Jews." Now, if you don't know Jesus' name in Hebrew, you can totally misunderstand this whole Bible verse. Because what it's saying is, for salvation is from the Jews. In Hebrew, salvation is the word Yeshua. And Yeshua means Jesus. So actually, this is what the Bible text says. It says, "You worship what you do not know. We worship what we know. For Yeshua," for Jesus, "is from the Jews." So salvation comes through Israel because Jesus was an Israelite. But only Yeshua can give you salvation. Can I give you salvation? Absolutely not. Can a rabbi give you salvation? Absolutely not. What it's speaking about, it's speaking about the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, Yeshua HaMashiach. You worship what you do not know, but we worship what we know. For Yeshua, for Jesus, is from the Jews. And I think that when you understand that Bible verse, then you no longer have a quest to look for rabbis and things. And I think that's part of the misunderstanding. Another Bible verse that's often misunderstood is Elohimayim, Romans chapter 1, verse 16, where Paul says, under the inspiration of the Ruach HaKodesh, the Holy Spirit, "For I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Yeshua the Messiah, for it is the power unto salvation to everyone that believes, to the Jew first, and also to the Gentile." And one thing I want to bring out, that Bible verse, when it says to the Jew first, in no way does it refer to the Jew better. On the contrary, if we read Elohimayim, Romans chapter 2, verses 9 to 11, we can understand what it means to the Jew first. "There will be a tribulation of distress for every soul of man who does evil, of the Jew first, and also to the Gentile. But glory and honor and peace to everyone who does good, to the Jew first, and also to the Gentile. For there is no partiality with God." So we see that with God, God is a just God. He's a God of mercy. He's a God of love. And when it says to the Jew first, it also means that the Jew will be judged first, because the Israelites received the Torah, the commandments, the Leviticus laws through Moses on Mount Sinai, and they received it first. And therefore, if they reject, they'll be judged first. And that's what it means in Romans chapter 1, verse 16 to 17, to the Jew first, and also to the Gentile. But it's very, very clear in Romans chapter 2 that there's no partiality with God. We're all the one new man, Ephesians 2:15. So many times people like to quote that verse to the Jew first, and then they quote John chapter 4:22, and they said salvation's from the Jews. And they think, okay, these Jews must have something special, so let's go follow the rabbis and start studying the Talmud. And I'm not saying that's the only reason, but I'm seeing that in many cases that's the reason. So I wanted to bring out that John 4:22 says that Yeshua is from the Jews. It has nothing to do with the Jewish people, because the Jewish people cannot give you salvation. The power comes from Jesus, from Yeshua, through the Holy Spirit. And Romans 1:16, to the Jew first In no way does it say to the Jew better. We're all the one new man working that harvest together, bringing in the last harvest until we all meet the Lord in the air and go home. Until next time, I'm Messianic Rabbi Zev Porat, sending you blessings from Israel, B'Shem Yeshua HaMashiach. Shalom.